I will say this is a pretty decent question for Calculus 2 students who want to have a challenge. Check this out. Suppose we know the improper integral going from negative infinity to positive infinity of sine x over x is equal to pi. We would like to know, what if we square this and square that? In fact, this is a pretty famous integral and I do have a video on this. But if you need to go from here to here, you actually just need some Calculus 2 stuff. So if you are taking Cal 2, this is for you. And please, pause the video and try this first. You did? Good. And let me tell you guys that the answer to this right here, it's also equal to pi. If you are surprised, let me tell you I'm surprised too. And now if you're thinking, what if we change the second power to the third power instead? Unfortunately, it's going to be different. Not my fault. I don't know. Not my fault. It only works for the first and also the second power. But anyway, let's see how we can take care of that. Here is the deal. We can actually just integrate this with integration by parts. So I'm going to use that right here. So put on the d and also the I, plus or minus. We will be differentiating sine squared x. And then we will integrate 1 over x squared. Okay, do this. We get 2 sine x. And don't forget the chain rule, so multiply by cosine x. And then do that, we get negative 1 over x. And now, this times that is the first part of the answer. So we will have negative sine squared x over x. And that's the first part. No more integral, right? So we have to plug in the negative infinity and also the infinity now. And then, don't forget we have to multiply these two things together and then put that itself an integral. This times that is positive. And then we have to integrate, and still going from negative infinity to positive infinity. Well, if you take a look right here, 2 sine x cosine x is in fact just sine of 2x, thanks to the double angle identity. Therefore, when we do this times that, we will just have sine of 2x on the top over x, like so. And then of course we have the dx here. Cool. Now let's talk about the first part here. Well, when we plug infinity, technically we are taking a limit as x goes to infinity. On the top, well, sine is at most 1. Sine squared is at most 1 as well. Negative is at most negative 1. And then divided by infinity, that will be 0. So when we do that, we get 0 first, right? And then when we plug in negative infinity, same story. So it's just 0 for the first part. And perhaps I'll just write down a bigger 0 for that, so just done deal for that. Very nice. So now, if we can figure this out, we'll be done. What is that? I don't think we can do integration by parts anymore. Well, if we don't know what to do, we are just going to do a use up. And especially, if we haven't used the given information, then you know something's not right. So here we go. We'll just do a use up right here. I will put U to be the inside. I think it's a good choice for you, and we'll see what happens. Okay, du will just be 2dx, and of course dx will just be du over 2. And now take this integral to the u world. You see, this is x going from negative infinity to positive infinity. If you take this, put it here, u will also go from negative infinity. You put infinity to here times 2, u will still be going to infinity as well. Here we have sine, and then the input is u because we said so here, and then we have x. Okay, u is equal to 2x, so we can just divide both sides by 2. We can say x is just equal to u over 2, so we can this have u over 2 here, and then dx is just du over 2, so let's go ahead and put that down, du over 2. Guess what, people? If you just look at the bottom, we have the over 2 right here and then multiply by 2. So this and that cancel. So in fact, this right here is just nicely equal to the integral going from negative infinity to positive infinity in the u world. And then we just have sine u over u du. And it doesn't matter if you are using u or t or whatsoever. As long as you have this, this and that match, and also this and that, it's just equal to pi. So in fact, this is just equal to pi. Ladies and gentlemen, the first part is 0, and then the second part is just that we will have to add the pi. So altogether, the answer is just nicely equal to pi. Just like that. So let me know what you guys think, and if you guys would like to see more intercourse like this, check out my other videos.